Let's draw the Lewis structure for CS2. This is carbon disulfide. So the first thing we do when we draw Lewis structures, we find the total number of valence electrons. And the periodic table, that can help us do that. So we find carbon here. That's in group 14, sometimes called 4A. That has 4 valence electrons. And then sulfur right here, group 16, sometimes called 6A, that has 6 valence electrons. We have 2 of those carbons. So 4 plus 12, that gives us 16 total valence electrons for the CS2 Lewis structure. So we put the least electronegative element in the center. That's going to be the carbon. So we'll have a carbon, and then we'll have a sulfur atom on either side. Next, we'll put 2 electrons between the atoms to form the chemical bond. This will be a covalent bond where they're sharing. Put 2 here, 2 here. We formed our chemical bond. Now we're going to go around the outside atoms, complete their octets, the sulfurs. After that, we can complete the octet on the central atom. The problem is we've already used all 16 of our valence electrons. So we're going to have to make a double bond or a triple bond here. We're going to have to share more electrons so that each of the atoms has an octet. We could move 2 here. That way the sulfur, that would have 8. And now the carbon has 6. We're getting closer. Why don't we move these 2 here, form another double bond. Now this sulfur has 8, this sulfur has 8, and the carbon, it has 8. And we're still using only 16 valence electrons for the CS2 Lewis structure here. So this is the correct Lewis structure for CS2. Sometimes you'll see these double bonds replaced with lines like this, where each line represents a pair of electrons. So that's another way you could draw it. Either way, this is the Lewis structure for CS2. If you're interested in the molecular geometry, this would be a linear molecular geometry. This is Dr. B with the Lewis structure for carbon disulfide. Thanks for watching.